So my name is Luke Boney, and I'm the Head of Mathematics and Professional Learning here at John Monash Science School. So the class you saw today was a Year 12 class. The students in it were of mixed ability. So some students in there have done a lot of coding and a lot of algorithm designs in the past, whereas others were just, this is brand new to them. Teaching math at John Monash is really about trying to get students to engage in the actual problem solving and logic. So we do a lot of work with students to try and really get them to understand how mathematics works and not just rote learn formulas. The students have done a lot of work in the lead up to this around what abstract data types are and how we use them in actually modelling algorithmic problems. And we've just started looking at things like time complexity of algorithms and writing pseudocode for algorithms. So that's what this lesson was largely about, actually figuring out how to write the pseudocode to describe an algorithm. So I structured the lesson with an engager at the beginning, which was the video on bubble sorting. And the video, okay, is basically modeling how a particular sorting algorithm works. Your task is going to be to actually watch it and then try and write down the pseudocode that describes that algorithm. So the video just showed basically a group of people doing a Hungarian dance as a representation of the bubble sort algorithm. I would recommend that you take some notes as you're watching this so that you can kind of remember how this is actually going. From there, I gave students the ability to first work individually to try and give them process time to actually interpret what it is. And that kind of, because in that classroom, the students who have done a lot of coding before and have a lot of experience tend to want to dominate the class. So ones who are not as familiar with it often don't get as much time to kind of process and really have a go themselves. Then the group work to give them a chance to discuss and share ideas and kind of build their understanding. Your next task is in groups of either two or three. I want you to share what you've done, and I want you to refine your models based on that discussion if it needs it. And just try and get a really comprehensive idea together of what your algorithm should actually end up being. Okay? So, from looking at that, right, you're looking at for every element in the array. So you look at it and you swap it if it's, and if it doesn't move, you leave it.
Basically, if they're in the wrong order.
Yeah, and if it doesn't, it stays the same and then you move to the next
then
element.
You just move to the next one, you just ignore it.
So, what would be the time complexity of this?
About n squared.
N squared.
Interesting. Then there was the co-construction on the board, where students shared their ideas and we talked about it and kind of fleshed it out a bit, and they kind of got the answer from that. And then a demonstration where they actually went away and found their algorithm under their chair and had a go at actually producing an explanation of that in the time that we had. Take a look under your chairs, putting the things under the chair for students to get up and actually check under the chair. That was designed as a different way of getting them into groups rather than just their friendship groups. So you've had a look under there. You've each got a type of sorting algorithm. What I want you to do is actually do a stop motion video, okay, of how that sorting algorithm would sort. Okay, I've got 5 numbers, okay, that I just want you to show how that would actually sort it. The reflection at the end, giving them the anonymity and the choice of what type of reflection they're actually going to give me, whether it's something that they were struggling with or something that they want to learn more about. Now up here, I have some yellow post-it notes and some purple ones. What I want you to do is I want you to choose either something that you didn't understand from today's lesson and write it on this post-it note, or something that you'd like to learn more about from this lesson and then write that on a yellow or green post-it note, whichever colour it is. The next job will be to actually look at it and collate it and see if there's any particular threads which are common and then address them in future lessons. So, you know, on a brief look over it, there was a lot of purple post-it notes around quicksorts, and so obviously the people who were working on quicksorts wanted to learn a bit more about how they actually worked.